Praise the Lord. Why not we? We thank God for this wonderful morning. The Lord has been good for us. He has taken good care of us throughout the week, and we are happy to thank God for this wonderful morning the Lord has given us. I know you are well at home. Keep it safe. Enjoy yourselves. Be good girls and boys, because the Lord has been good to us. Today we are blessed to have Teacher Pauline with us, whom we shall pray together, hear the word of God together, and we shall be blessed. This morning I'm blessed, and the Lord is moving my soul. Let's pray as we start the word of the day. Everlasting Lord, we thank you for this wonderful morning. Thank you for your goodness and mercy, O God. Thank you for taking care of us throughout the week, and you have made us to see this wonderful day. We commit ourselves to love you and to serve you, O God. Protect our children, protect our parents, and protect each and every person, O God. Thank you for your unfaithful God. This we pray and trust in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Wow, I'm happy to see that the Lord has been doing good things to us. I know we have enjoyed last week. We learned something which was so encouraging, and I know you are keeping it in practice. Let's continue doing the same, enjoying the word of God, and serving God at home and praying, because our God is so faithful. At this moment, I will welcome our teacher, Teacher Pauline, so as she can take us through the word of God of the day. May God bless you. Welcome, Teacher Pauline.
Thank you. Yes, you have heard. My name is Teacher Pauline. We are present to have our lesson today. And today, I just want us to learn something very small about trust God. I want us to learn about trust God. About trusting God, how do you trust? Whom do you trust in your life? Whom do you trust in each and everything you have in your life? At the end of this lesson, children will learn trusting God in difficult situations. Children will learn trusting God in each and everything. And that's why I thought of our teaching for today is trusting God, putting our trust in God, putting our focus in God. As you have seen nowadays, things are very hard. I want us as children to run in trusting God, run in focusing in God in each and everything. And our reading today is taken from the book of Genesis, chapter 22, from verse 1 to 19. Children here at home, with the help of your parents, will go through that chapter and see what God did for Abraham. I hope the same God is going to do us and to us as children. You all know the story about Abraham. Abraham was present with a child when he was too old. He had prayed for that child for many years. In fact, Abraham gave birth. Sarah, at the time when he was giving birth, he was 100 years. Can you imagine somebody who is 100 years giving birth? I don't think it was possible, but God blessed Sarah when he was 100 years, and he gave birth to a child called Isaac. And at that time, God called Abraham, and he told him, "Abraham, I want you to sacrifice your only son." Abraham could not believe. Abraham was told to sacrifice his only son by God. By the time Abraham was being called by God, Isaac was not there. Abraham is the one who talked with God. So he was told to sacrifice his only son. Abraham could not believe. He had a very difficult situation, but because he trusted in God and he trusted his child in God's hand, he did not refuse. One day, he took Isaac together with his two servants. They started their journey to go and give that burnt offering to God. In fact, God asked Abraham to sacrifice a burnt offering to him. Before Abraham was sacrificing to God, it is not that he not used to sacrifice to God. He used to sacrifice best of his animal, best of his ram, but this time God needed Abraham to sacrifice his only son, the one he, which he loved. He did not have any other child. It is only Isaac. So one day they started their journey. Abraham had to carry charcoal, water, everything which could be used in the sacrifice. But he did not have the ram to sacrifice to God. Now bearing in mind, he did not refuse. Abraham took his son Isaac with him, together with his two servants. The journey which they started took them 3 days. It was not the place where God wanted Abraham to go, the sacrifice to him was not near. So they had to take 3 good days for them to reach the place where God had told him. He put everything in a donkey, which helped them to carry. At those times there were no vehicles to carry luggage, so they had to use their donkey. Abraham was helped by 2 of his servants, which they went with him. So they went for 3 good days. At a distance, Abraham saw the place where God wanted him to sacrifice for him. He left 2 of his servants there and went with Isaac. They carried their things with Isaac. When they were with Isaac, Isaac asked his father, "Father, I can see we have all the things which you are going to sacrifice. Where is the ram?" Abraham would not answer his son, but he told his son Isaac, "God will provide." Meaning, Abraham had put his trust in God. He knew God was going to provide. And because he had put his trust in God, he knew God will provide the ram which they are going to sacrifice to him. They went to his boy Isaac. Deep in his thoughts, he did not have something to sacrifice. But back in his mind, he knew God is going to provide for them the ram which they are going to sacrifice. Imagine, who are you at this moment? Isaac is there with his father, walking comfortably without the lamb which they are going to sacrifice. His father knew he is going to sacrifice his son, but the son did not know. Is the lamb which the Lord has seen to be sacrificed to him. They went, they reached the place. His father made an altar to sacrifice to the Lord, but he had nothing to sacrifice. But he knew God had chosen Isaac to be sacrificed as the lamb which God had seen. Isaac was there. His father took Isaac, tied him, akamchukua, akamfunga miguu, akamweka juu ya altar, so that he can sacrifice his son. Hebu imagine, even while you are there with your father is going to sacrifice you as the sacrifice. How would you feel? You can see your father is tied to a leg, ready to sacrifice you as the lamb. But Abraham had trust in God. He could do nothing because he trusted in this God. When they were there, his father lifted a knife, ready to kill his boy. Let me just imagine. And Isaac was there comfortably, right in the altar, waiting to be sacrificed. Children there at home, imagine if you were you. Being your father is ready, preparing to kill you. How would you feel? Imagine Isaac did not refuse. When he was about to sacrifice his son, the Lord came because Abraham trusted in God. He turned around and seen a lamb tied up at the head by the bush. And then the Lord said, "Do not kill your son. I have seen your trust in me." Now, children there at home, with the help of that story about Abraham and Isaac, we are told to trust in God. The story tells us to trust in God. Abraham trusted in God. He did not refuse. He was told to sacrifice his only son. The son himself did not refuse. Now I want us to start focusing at Abraham. The way he trusted God. The way he kept his thoughts in God. There at home, whom do you trust? Whom do you trust when you need something? Whom do you trust when you are in difficult situations? A time like now, everybody, name them, your aunt, your father, your mother, your shosho, all of us are in a difficult situation. A time like now, whom are you trusting? Whom are you trusting? I want us to trust. We start building our trust in God. We start engaging God in our trust. In each and everything you want to do, just trust the Lord. And that's why Abraham named the place where he was sacrificing his son. God will provide, because God provided. At this moment, whom are you trusting? Just, I want us to start trusting God. Even at the moment, we just trust God. One day, one time, we are going back to school. One day, one time, we'll go into our classes and start worshiping God as we normally do. Teacher Joyce, who do you trust? Where have you kept your trust? Many of us are trusting our parents. Many of us are trusting our profession. At a time like that, at a time like now, many of us have put their trust in the ministry of health. But from this moment, I want us to start trusting in God. Like what Abraham did. Abraham trusted in God. And that's why we see in the Bible, Abraham is called the father of faith. Because he kept his faith in God and trusted in God. And everything was done by God because he trusted him. In this lesson, I want us as children, we start trusting in God in the difficult situation. We keep our trust in God so that God can fulfill our promises, so that God can bless us. After Abraham trusting in God, God blessed him with a ram which he was going to sacrifice to him. If we want blessings from God, we must trust Him. If we want God to bless us, we must trust in God. Now, there at home, I want us to trust. If you have not been trusting God, please, just start trusting in God. And God is going to do wonders. As He did to Abraham, He's also going to do to us. By this I mean, in each and everything, not to trust God today and tomorrow because you do not trust God, you trust your mother or your father. I want us to trust in God. By the end of this lesson, I want us to build our trust in God. If you have kept your trust somewhere else, please trust in God, like Abraham did. Also, I want us, we start focusing our trust in God in difficult situations. Whenever you find yourself in a difficult situation, trust in God and He's going to do to bless you. Because He's the one who has said that He has told us we trust in Him. That's why I told you, Abraham trusted in God. If you imagine, Abraham had no other son. To say me kama ni wewe, umezaliwa tu wewe peke yako. Una brother, una sister, ni wewe tu peke yako. Na Mungu aseme, aambie baba yako ama mama to sacrifice you yourself. Hata kama ni wewe unaweza kubali. Obvious, I think it's a no. Hakuna mtu anaweza kubali. Lakini Abraham did not refuse. He agreed to go with Isaac. Isaac spent 3 days walking with his father to give a sacrifice to God. That's why we see also had another faith in trusting in God. Now put yourself in that shoe of Isaac. Could you have walked with his father to be the sacrifice you have? Also Isaac had a trust in God. And I want all of us to start trusting in God. We trust in God even for the things which we don't know. Like a time like now we have been told we shall go to school by January. Trust in God. so that God can do us through, so that God can be our Lord, so that we can trust in each and everything. So children there at home, whom do you trust from now? Whom do you trust there at home? We trust the God whom we believe in, God. That's why he did not refuse to sacrifice to God. He knew the God whom he is going to sacrifice to is the God whom we trust in, whom we trusted for, so that he can be a strong in his life. That's our thought. So we wanted to amini at the Mungu anaenda kutuonekania, Mungu anaenda kutulinda, Mungu anaenda kutufanyia mambo makuu. Now, even if you are not so good, just trust God. He love you in whatever situation you are. Hata kama wewe sio mzuri sana, trust God. Mungu atakupenda tu vile ulivyo. You trust God. Hata kama wewe ufanyi vizuri sana, ati Mungu ataenda kufanya maisha yako inawiri. From this lesson, I just want us to trust God with our future. Just trust God with our future. The future which you don't know, you trust God is going to do many things in your future. And now, as we end our lesson, I want us, by the next week, you take our memory verse, so that you can memorize and know who you are going to trust, and trust in God forever. Now this memory verse is going to come from the book of Isaiah 26 and verse 4. With the help of your parent, open your Bible at your own convenient time and study this memory verse, which is taken from the book of Isaiah 26 from verse 4, which says, "Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord is eternal." And we trust in the Lord forever. Not one day or 2 days or 1 week. Trust in the Lord forever. Parents, they are at home. Please help your children to read this memory verse and help them to trust in the Lord so that they can trust God in each and everything they are planning to do. And at all circumstances, they will learn to trust the Lord, especially at this difficult situation. That's why a lot of us learning about trusting the Lord and keeping our trust in the Lord. From this time, children, you learn to trust the Lord. At all times, you learn to focus our minds on the Lord and building our trust in the Lord. So from this time, just increase your trust in the Lord, and the Lord is going to do wonders. He's going to bless us. He's going to heal us from this deadly disease if we only trust in the Lord, so that he will deliver us from this difficult situation. Be blessed and welcome in our next lesson. Thank you, children, for watching and for listening. And don't forget to trust the Lord.
Thank you.
Let's pray for today. You just want us to pray and you trust which and everything we are going to pray. Our Lord is listening and our Lord is going to help us so that we can trust in him and meditate upon the word for today. Thank you, Lord, because you have been our Father. Thank you, Lord, because of taking for us. My Lord and my Father, we just want us to trust in you in each and everything. Thank you, Lord, because you have guided us and helped us, O God, throughout the week. Oh, my Father, you have been with us. As we are going to start our week next week, thank you, Lord, because you are going to watch over us. You are going to guide us, oh, my Father. Bless these young ones, oh, my Father. They are back at home, oh, my Father. Be with them, guide them, protect them, oh, my Father. Whenever they have done wrong, oh, my Father, forgive them so that they can walk hand in hand with you. And above all, my Father, protect them, oh, my Father, so that they may not fall into any danger or meet any danger, oh, my Father. Let their treatment be directed by you. Thank you, Lord, for their parents. We commit them into your heavenly hands, oh, my Father, as they walk each and every day, oh, my Father, trying to get something for these young ones, oh, my Father. Protect them, lead them, oh, my Father. Thank you, Lord, because you know these young children, oh, my Father, have the desire. you are sanctuary, but they cannot do so, my Father, because they are not around, my Father. We are trusting in you and keeping all our trust in you, that a time will come, my Father, where we will praise you and glorify you in your sanctuary. Thank you, Father, because you are the one who has made us the way we are. We just glorify and pray to your holy name, my Father, for each and every thing. Glory and honor shall be yours. We thank you, Father, and pray to your holy name, O God, because you are our Father and our God. There is no other God apart from you. That's why you have trusted, that's why you have put our trust in you. We thank you and glorify you, O God. Lead us, guide us, O my Father, protect us, O my Father. Not even remembering, forgetting our church, O my Father, which has given us this moment, O my Father, so that we can minister unto your children. We glorify and pray for you, O my Father, because you are Father and our Lord. Lead us, guide us, O my Father, and sit in Jesus' mighty name we pray and believe. Amen.
So blessed. I've learned to trust in God every time, forever. Not today, but every time I have learned to trust in God. Our children, they are at home, kindly, as we have learned from Teacher Pauline. Let's put our trust in God and we shall remain blessed. We are happy to have you. We are happy that you are watching. They are at home so that we can learn together. May God bless you and have a blessed one.